The doctors and nurses at Trottingham General did an excellent job of caring for her. If they hadn't managed to make the magical skin gaps and tooth regrowing enchantments take so well, there's no way we'd be seeing her cutie mark again to tell who she is, much less have an accurate dental prints to confirm it.
How long do you think her coma will last with the proper medi-magic treatments?
Hard to say. The brain is the most complex organ in the body, and it doesn't respond well to magical interference. Our only real course of action is to heal her body and wait to see whether that allows her to wake up naturally.
So your informed opinion is wait and see?
Cadence. Spike. You came. I was not sure.
Save it. We're here for Twilight, not you.
Dr. Stable, would you mind giving us a moment? Princess Cadence and I need to talk.
Huh? Yes, of course. I'll go and, see about those transfer papers for Nurse Redheart to Canterlot Hospital.
Twilight! Twilight!
Hold, little one.
Twilight!
The doctor was very precise that we are not to touch her. Moving her from Trottingham to Canterlot was arduous enough upon her body, and she is very frail at present.
But what happened to her? Why was she in Trottingham? Why didn't we know she's alive until now? Why is she all covered in bandages still? Tell me!
I will answer all of your questions, little one, if you promise to comply with the doctor's wishes.
Okay. Just, Princess Luna, please. Is she going to be okay?
I do not know. From what we can surmise, and the survivors of Xanthos's raid on the royal caravan can remember, Celestia teleported Twilight away from the scene of the attack before doing away with Xanthos and her forces herself. Twilight attempted to stop Celestia from sending her away, and Celestia was forced to overpower her to ensure she escaped, which caused the damage to Twilight's horn that you can see. Overloading her magical synapses and the damage from the forced teleport is what probably resulted in her falling into a coma. My sister's attempts were, unfortunately, not enough to completely save Twilight from damage. She was very badly burned. No pony could tell who she was when she landed in Trottingham. They have been caring for her there as an anonymous patient until recently, when they finally managed to identify her.
And you had her brought here rather than leaving her where she was? No matter how dangerous that might be for her?
Canterlot has some of the finest medical researchers in all of Equestria. They will work tirelessly to help her. I have even brought her preferred physician from Ponyville to take care of her as well, so that she has someone familiar to answer her questions when she wakes to ease her stress levels.
And screw all his other patients who prefer his work in Ponyville, I guess.
Princess Luna? What the doctor said about not knowing whether Twilight will wake up? Do you think he's right?
I am no doctor, little one. I see to his wisdom in all things medical.
But there is something you could do, isn't there?
Excuse me?
You're the Princess of the Night, aren't you? Well, isn't a coma just like sleeping? You could go into her mind and wake her up!
I don't...
Well, can't you?
I don't do that anymore.
Can you at least try, Princess Luna? Please? For Twilight?
I cannot. I am sorry.
But why?
I have my reasons, little one.
You really are a disgusting piece of—
Cadence!
No, Spike. I came here because of Twilight, not her. After all this time thinking she was dead, we find out Twilight is alive. It's a miracle. And she has a power that might help Twilight come back to us fully, but she refuses to even try using it? You disgust me. I wish it had been you who died instead of Celestia.
I wish that too.
Don't! Don't you dare try that self-pity crap with me! You've done too much for me to ever feel sorry for you! We've all lost something, Luna. We all lost ponies we care about! Friends and family! Ponies we love! You're not special!
I know.
Stop it! Just stop it! I can't even stand to look at you! Spike, I'm leaving. You can stay if you like, but I can't be in the same room as this! As this! Ah!
Twilight would want me to look after her. Cadance is the only family she has left now. Cadance, wait for me!
Oh, Twilight Sparkle. What have I done to you? I'm so sorry. I never should have meddled. I swear, I will never again go into the minds of others where I do not belong. I will look after you, my friend.